everyone. It's Thumper the Rabid Rabbit. And I'm here doing the thing I said I wasn't going to do, which is I'm playing around on staging. Got bored, had a few drinks last night, set up a staging server on my computer here to see what vanilla staging looked like. Few things that I noticed right away. The weather seems to be on by default. It's foggy out here, so all right. They seem to have gotten rid of shadows in the fog, which is interesting. Also, I believe we're on the newer Unity engine now, and this kind of took me by surprise. I don't know about you, but on most servers I play on, I can't make foundations spawn this fast, like as fast as I click. So I don't know if that's a Unity performance improvement, but it kind of took me by surprise that it was that quick. So that's cool. Yeah. So, oh yeah, and when it's foggy, solar panels still work. They still get power. Let me, sun's going down right now because I don't have any mods on here. Set it back to noon so you can see that I'm not lying to you. It's noon. Server time right now is noon. And you can see full 20 units of power, even though it's foggy and you can't see anything. I think it does the same thing with clouds last time I checked too, so that's cool. It's actually a little more realistic. Solar panels do get power when it's foggy out. They still get, you know, infrared radiation. So usually not as much, so maybe they'll change it in the future so that fog and clouds mean less power. But right now you still get full power, so that's great. The thing that everyone is most excited about on staging right now is this thing, the HBHF. Some of these are actually in the... Yeah, here we go. Here it is. Some of these are actually in the inventory already, which kind of suggests maybe that they're going to be available. We still got 6 more days before the next main branch release, so... maybe the HBHF sensor. It stands for heartbeat, breathing, humidity, footsteps, with a 20 meter radius. And here's an interesting thing. It doesn't pass through the power you put in. It passes through the number of people that are detected in that radius. So that's another interesting twist here. It's not the same as like a laser sensor or a pressure pad that just tell you we're on and we're going to put all of our power through. This thing puts through just the number of people that it is sensing, so that will be fun for criteria based stuff. Before, you would have had to have like a laser sensor count up how many people break the beam and hope that people weren't walking back and forth through it. So if I get out my wire tool here, you'll see it's got an input, an output, and interestingly enough, you don't change modes with the wire tool, you change modes with the hammer. It needs power, so let me put some power on it real quick here. And I'm gonna give it like 10 for now. You can see it has an output of 1 because it's detecting me. One person, one output. When I'm on the hammer, you'll see here's its modes. You can include or exclude authorized people. That's why it's picking me up right now, because it's including both authorized and unauthorized. So if I turn off authorized players, include others, exclude others. Oh wait, yeah, include authorized. Oh, that's me. Exclude authorized, include others. There you go. So now it won't set off for me anymore. See, it's output 0 because I told it to exclude authorized people. That's the mode you'd want to use if you're trying to do like a raid detection or something like that. Despite its name, just consider it a proximity sensor. It works about 3 squares away and it works line of sight. Let me hook up a couple other new components here so you can see that. There's this blue flashing light and this red beacon light. They call it a flasher light, which is blue, and siren light, which is just a spinning beacon light. Siren Light almost suggests that it should have sound with it, but it doesn't. Otherwise, I probably would have called it Beacon Light, but maybe that's just a language or whatever thing. Also, since this only puts out the number of power units that it is detecting, if you want to use it as a trigger, with me here, it's only going to give me one unit of power. So, yeah, see when I'm here, only one unit of power. So I'm going to put it into an AND switch to trigger this other 10 units to go through off of the branch. Because, yeah, that's going to be a problem. So now I at least have a couple units of power here I can bring down. And boom. And this one on too. So that's what the new lights look like. And so now we have two more power consumers, a flashing light and a rotating light. And they're pretty visible, so that's helpful. The other thing I want to show off here is we have some like radio remote tools. I'm going to drop a flasher over here for this demonstration and show you these two things. RF, there they are. RF broadcaster, not really verbose. RF receiver, not really verbose. Neither of them have a model yet. They both look like lamps. So, will they come out this week? Maybe-ish. I mean, they're in the inventory, and maybe they'll give them a model by Thursday. So, here's what happens when you hook up this RF transmitter. When it has power, it turns on. You set a frequency that's unique. I think it'll take all the way up to the 10 million number combination here. So, I'm calling it 6969 because, of course, I do. And then this receiver unit also looks like a lamp right now. And you have to set its frequency the same as the transmitter if you want it to trigger, but it does need power, so that's why I dropped another solar panel over here. And you see it's on. And if I walk out of range of this sensor, that turns off power to the transmitter, so no power to the receiver, or no signal to the receiver, so it turns off. But boom. So this would be great for like remote raid detection. Put this in your like secondary base or your raid base or wherever where you happen to be working at the moment, and then put that in your main base. So while you're out raiding, if you see lights come on your raid base and somebody's at your house messing with your stuff. The next step up from that, which will be pretty cool, and this isn't in the inventory yet, but I can still spawn it, so I'll show it to you, is this pager. It says it listens on frequency 55. That doesn't actually work right now. Here, I'll set this to 55 and show you, like, pager doesn't do anything with that transmitting on 55. So, it's clearly not done yet. It doesn't show up in the inventory, but it will be, like, the quintessential raid notification tool, because you would put this HFBF or pressure pad or laser in your base. When somebody comes into your base, you trigger the transmitter beeps your pager and says, hey, somebody just walked into your stuff. And that would work anywhere, presumably on the map, no matter what you're doing. So you don't have to be like in another base where you have this receiver set up. It's the portable pager would be the portable receiver. And finally, one other RF component is the detonator. This is in the inventory. And let's see, its description is handheld broadcaster, left click to broadcast, right click to configure. So I hold down right click, and here I can set the same frequency, 6969. That wasn't the default, I just set it earlier, in case you were wondering. Watch this. When I'm out of range and not triggering anything, that receiver over there is still set to 6969. So left click, it's on, release, it's off. It stays on as long as you're holding it. So, it says kaboom on it, but there's not really any explosives that are electrically triggered yet. But if you wanted to set up a little base, somebody asked me once, how do you set up a 1x1 that just blows people away when they come close to it, but not like give it away? Well, you know, lasers and pressure pads are, you can hide them a little bit, but not perfectly, and those who are looking for them would know. But you could certainly set up a 1x1, stand back on a hill, and anytime somebody walks close to your 1x1, go boop. And boom, all the doors open and blow them to smithereens. So this is going to be a fun one. I feel like all these components we're looking at here have a reasonable chance of going to release on Thursday. Maybe the RF transmitter and receiver won't if they don't have new models. But everything else seems to work relatively well. There is one other electrical, not an RF, but electrical component, and that is the RAND switch. Okay, here we go. So the description says it allows pass-through based on a random number. Each time the set input receives power, it'll roll true or false. So it's a coin flip. It's a 50-50 chance of whether it's going to be on or not. It behaves a lot like a memory cell. Power in, power out. When it's on or true, it puts out power. When you reset it, it would go back to off. But a memory cell, every time you put power on set, it's going to go to true or on until you reset it. This guy is, you got a 50-50 chance apparently of whether it's going to turn on, which could be really fun for a trap base or a puzzle base where you want to add some random variability to the equation. Maybe it doesn't go off every time somebody walks in. Maybe the doors in your puzzle base don't open every time someone puts in the right combination of switches. Maybe they're just getting a random chance of it opening. So that could be fun. I have a laser detector on the wall here for a reason, because I also had a pressure pad on the ground. Let me grab one of those, put it back down. The reason I did that is because I wanted to show off that some of these new components aren't quite mature yet. Remember that you can't pick up a pressure pad and you can't pick up a laser detector? Well, you can pick up the RAND because it's based off of an existing component. You can pick up the RF receiver because the lamp model apparently supports that. You can pick up the transmitter, cannot pick up the lights. So once you craft them and place them, they're stuck there just like the laser and pressure pads. So invest wisely in those. If you have a remove plugin on your server, you'll still be able to slash remove them, but can't pick them up on vanilla. And then you can't pick up the HBHF. So you just have to destroy it or slash remove it, I guess. So these are all components that, you know, they got a pretty good chance of making it into main, I would think or hope, and we'll have a lot of fun with those. One last thing before I go, some people ask me about the generator because it's been in the game for a while. It's not in the inventory, you can't get it as a user yet, but some servers let you have them or spawn them. Admins can spawn them for you because they've been in the main branch, they're just not available. I don't know if they'll ever be craftable, but they basically are like a large battery that never runs out. They don't take anything right now. They don't take any input, any fuel. They just give you 100 power all the time, which is great if you can get them on your server right now. I'm assuming before these will go to release, they'll make them use fuel or something. I imagine they probably wouldn't be craftable. You'd probably have to find them in high tier crates or something, but we'll see. They've been in main for a while and they work. They just don't have any fuel consumption, so they'd be super OP if they actually put them in main right now. So yes, those do exist. For those who are wondering, they're not just a visual model. They do exist as a device. But yeah. So there's all the new components that are in the staging branch. Along with some, you know, new weather and feels like some higher performance. I guess we can expect to see a bunch of this on Thursday, but we'll just have to wait and see. So that's it for now on the staging branch component review. Good luck and don't suck.